Welcome back. We have seen our first two chapters of EBS, that is going to school and year to year. Now, in this session, we are going to start with our third chapter. I have shown you a beautiful picture of elephants on this slide. Let's start with the lesson. Okay. So my first question to all of you is, have you ever gone for a jungle safari? Yes, have you gone for a jungle safari? Write your answers in the comment box. Have you visited a zoo? Yes, if you have visited a zoo, write down there. Which animal did you see? Which animals you have seen in the zoo? You have to write it down. Name some animals which have gray skin. Write there. Which animals have a very long nose and teeth? Write it there. Which animal is there in the movie Dumbo? Have you seen a movie Dumbo? Okay, if you have not seen, no problem. You can see it afterwards because you will enjoy that movie. And those who have seen, you can write the name of the animal over there. Can you guess who is there in our new lesson? Can you tell me the name of the animal who is there in our new lesson? Okay, let's see. Okay, yes, you are right. We are going to learn about elephants in this chapter. Okay. Now, what is the name of the lesson? The name of the lesson is A Day with Nandu. So, I have shown you one nice small baby elephant. Now, you will imagine why ma'am has shown this pic of an elephant. So, this entire lesson is based on elephant's life cycle. Okay, let's see. So, you all are very much close to your family, right? You are very much close to your grandparents, your uncle, aunt, your cousins, your mama, mommy. Okay, like us, these elephants also have their own family. They have bonding with their own family. So, as we all are very attached with our grandparents, with our mama, daddy, with our cousins, with our relatives, these elephants also attach to their family members. Let's see what this lesson wanted to teach us. Now, there is one more slide. You have to write the names of your family members in the given space. If it is not possible here, it will be not possible for you to write the names here. You can draw this family tree in your rough notebook and write down the names of your grandparents, mama, daddy, and your name. Okay. Now, let's see what this Nandu wanted to tell you. See, Nandu wakes up. Nandu woke up and opened his eyes. For a very few seconds, he was not sure where he was. It seems to him that he was surrounded by a forest of big gray tree trunk. He blinked his eyes and looked around. Oh, there was Amma. Okay, so Nandu get up in the morning. When he opened his eyes, for a few seconds, he was not knowing where he was. Okay, so he was confused. So he seems that he is surrounded by a big gray tree trunks. Okay, so he thought that he was surrounded by a big gray tree trunks. He started to blink his eyes. Blink his eyes means to open and close. He started to blink his eyes and look around and started to look here and there. Then he realized, oh, it's my mom. Okay. Oh, there was Amma. Amma means his mother. Okay. Now, the gray forest that he had imagined he was in, actually, where he was? He was actually the legs and trunk of his family members. So, he thought that he is in the forest of big gray trunk. Like this trunk means big branches of a tree which are gray in color, but actually that was the legs of his family members and he was surrounded among the legs of his family members. Okay, you can see in the pic I have shown you to understand it more clearly. You can see the big trunk of his mother and that Nandu is in between that trunk. Okay, now what he wanted to tell you, the sun was overhead. Overhead means it was afternoon time and it was getting hot. As it is afternoon, it was getting very hot. Nanima trumpet made a loud sound. Okay, Nanima means his granny. Nanima is the oldest in his herd of elephants. She was the oldest person in the herd of elephants. Herd means a group of elephants. She started moving towards the jungle. Nanima started moving towards the jungle. The other family members, like the other female elephants, saw her and started to follow her. Nandu also went with them. Okay, his Nanima started to walk towards the jungle. Okay, as she was the older person of his family, and the other female elephants also follow her. They also started to go behind her, and this poor chap Nandu also started to follow his mother. Okay, when they reached the jungle, the members of the herd started spreading out. Each member went to eat her favorite leaves and twigs. Okay, when they reached the jungle, each and every member just disperse means they went here and there to eat their favorite food. Okay, so this Nandu also, a poor chap, he also went with his mama and he was searching for the food. Okay, now where do this elephant live? This elephant live in the forest. Okay, so what does this forest give them? Forest give them, yes, good climatic conditions to live. Forest give them water, food. Okay, so everything is available for the elephants to live there. So elephants live in the forest. So his family members went here and there and they started to eat food which they are getting. Now see what they wanted to tell you. See, you can see a pig here. One is eating grass, one is eating branches, and other is eating leaves. So they have different types of food items to eat in the jungle, right? Even we also like different food items to eat. Every day if mama prepares brinjal vegetable for you, will you able to eat it every day? No, it becomes very difficult. So these elephants also eat different kinds of food in the jungle. Okay, you can see they are taking leaves from the branches also, right? So what this elephant like to eat? Animals are categorized according to their feeding habits. Means what they like, they are categorized, means animals are divided into according to their feeding habits. So if elephant is eating grass, lion will not eat a grass. So they are categorized, they are placed into that groups. So in third standard, you have already learned about animals eating habit, like herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous. So herbivorous means these animals that feed on plants and leaves. Okay, herbivorous are the animals that feed only on plants and not on other animals. They like to eat only plants. So what is meant by herbivorous? Herbivorous means the animals, they eat only plants. Okay, so elephants are in the category of herbivorous animals. They eat only grass. Okay, and we have shown you some examples here on the screen, like rabbit, sheep, deer, then the squalla. So these animals eat only grass. Okay, along with this, I am going to send you one link of animals eating habit. You just see that link. That means your doubts will be clear. Now, do you know an adult elephant can eat more than 100 kilograms of leaves and twigs in one day? Oh my God! Do you know this? An adult elephant can eat more than 100 kilograms of leaves and twigs in one day. Really, how much they eat, right? But they eat that much and digest only 44% of what they eat. So they have to eat a lot. Okay, so animal feeds 12 to 8 hours a day. Elephant feeds 18 hours a day. See, An adult elephant can eat more than 100 kilograms of leaves and twigs in a day. So, only 44% of food is digested throughout the day. That's why they have to eat a lot. And elephant feed round about 12 to 18 hours a day. They are only eating. Okay. An adult elephant eat about 100 kg of leaves in a day. See, imagine an adult elephant eats 100 kg of leaves in a day. Oh my God, isn't it very surprising? Okay, elephants do not rest very much. They are not taking rest, or they are not taking sleep for 8 to 9 hours or 7 to 8 hours. They take hardly 2 to 4 hours rest. Like, they sleep for only 2 or 4 hours in a day, and rest other time they are just only eating leaves and twigs. Okay, now let's see some facts about elephants. We have to see, elephants are mammals. Mammals means they have ears and hairs on their body, so they are giving birth to the young ones. Did you understand what is meant by mammals? Mammals means the animals, those who have ears and hairs, they give birth to the young ones. So elephants are mammals. Elephants are the largest land animal on earth. Okay, you can see them. As you know, it has a huge body. So elephants are the largest land animal on the earth. They are one of the most unique looking animals too, right? It is my favorite animal, so it must be favorite animal of yours also, right? So elephant family are led by females, and the oldest person of the family leads the entire herd. As you know, we have already discussed, Nandu's granny started to walk. Hence, Nandu's grandma started to walk towards the jungle, and rest other all female elephants started to follow her. Why she was only one person to go ahead? Because in elephants, the whole herd is led by an eldest person of the family. So Nanima is an eldest person of the family, so entire family listens to her and they just follow. Okay, now what we have seen in this chapter today, in this session, we have learned about relationship between our family members, and we have even seen animals bonding with their family members like that of Nandu. Let's see what we see in our next chapter, next session. Thank you.